Hello everyone, I am Prajwal Agarwal and today we'll solve this question, minimum operations. This problem is rated as easy on CodeChef and you need some basic maths to solve this question. So guys, if you haven't read the problem yet, go back and read it, try it out and then come back and see the solution. With this, let's begin. In this problem, we are given an integer x and we want to convert this x into a number y such that this y is divisible by 2. So now to do this, we are allowed to do two operations on the number x. In the first operation, we can add 1 to x. So we can write x is equal to x plus 1. And in the second kind of operation, we can subtract 1 from x. So we can write x is equal to x minus 1. And we can perform these operations however we want and how many number of times we want. We want to change x to a number y such that this is divisible by 2. We have to do this in minimum number of operations and output it into our final answer. In the constraints, we are given test cases from 1 to 1000. X will range from 0 to 10 to the power 9. So now let us look at some test cases. In the first test case, we are given x is equal to 4 and we know that 4 is divisible by 2. So we don't need to do any operation, hence our answer is 0. In the second test, we are given x is equal to 0. Now we know that 0 is divisible by 2. Hence, we do not need to do any kind of operation, so our answer is 0. So now let us look at the solution. In this problem, we are given an integer x and we want to convert it into an integer such that it is divisible by 2. To do this, we are allowed to do two operations. In the first operation, we can add 1 to x or we can subtract 1 to x. So now one of the main observations here to note is, for any given integer x, there are two cases. The first is that x is even. So if x is even, we can say that x modulo 2 will be equal to 0 and in this case x is already divisible by 2. So in this case our answer is nothing but 0. Now we have another case where x is odd. So in this case what we can do is, we know that x is odd, this means that x plus 1 will be even. Hence, we can say that we can actually perform the first operation of type 1 and we only need to do this only once. We need to perform this operation only once. We will get a new integer x plus 1 and this x plus 1 will be even, so it will be divisible by 2. So in this case, our answer is equal to 1 because we are doing only one operation. So overall, the idea is to check whether the x is even or odd. So we can write if x mod 2 is equal to 0, then in this case we will simply print 0. Else we know that x is odd, so we will convert x to x plus 1 using the first operation and we will get an even number. So we can simply print 1. Because we are doing exactly one operation. So the overall time complexity of this solution is order of 1. The space complexity is also order of 1. So now let us look at the code. So first of all, we will take the input and then we will go to the solve function. In this, we will take the input n and if the value of n is odd, then we will print 1, else we will print 0. So guys, this is pretty much the whole code. Try to code it yourself and if you face an issue, then come back and see it again. So now let us look at the code. This code has been written in Python 3.6. So we will process the input first. Then we will check the value of n is odd or not. If it is even, then we will print 0, else we will print 1. So guys, this is pretty much the whole code and it passes all the test cases. So guys, one of the common mistakes in this question is that be careful how you are taking the input. Although your logic might be correct, however, if you forget to take the input, let's say the number of test cases or the value of x, then in that case, you will get wrong answers. So guys, I hope you understood the problem clearly. If you have any questions, drop a comment in the comment section. Like the video and don't forget to subscribe to get our latest updates from CodeChef. Thank you and goodbye.